This video is brought to you by Morning Brew. What just happened? I picked the worst time to do a coverage on the WWDC event. All I could hear was Craig Federighi saying next, 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 while my fingers are trying to catch up on the notes. Also, did someone manage to count the number of presenters that came out during the event? At one point, there was a Japanese person saying something too fast to read in the subtitles, let alone take notes. It was such a jam-packed event that the new M2 MacBook Air was introduced as if it was a new Apple Watch complication. Anyway, I'll go through the event as it was presented to the world, and I'll share with you what I'm most excited about, and there's a lot this time. As always, I'll be suffering through the unofficial public releases as soon as they come out, so if you'd like to see what it's like to live with the new software features and their implementations, subscribe to the channel, and let's get right to it. And good luck to all the developers, by the way. iOS 16 killed it with the new lock screen options. The new iPhone OS will allow us to customize the phone screens as if we were creating an Apple Watch complication. The depth effect that we enjoyed on the watch is here, and personalization is vast, including fonts, which is surprising for Apple. We can have multiple lock screens that can include various designs, including widgets. I think I enjoyed the weather one the most. The animations upon unlock are fantastic, by the way. Notifications will now roll from the bottom so that they don't obscure the screen, and live activities like watching game results will be at a glance away too. I'll probably end up enjoying the new Apple Music activity most of the time, which embraces the album art just right. We will also be able to use toggle between focus modes thanks to the lock screens. Now, because of my time zone, by the way, I relish old keynotes at night, and it's midnight here. On the following day, one of my favorite post-Apple event moments is reading all the reactions from the people and the media. My information diet is rigorous, and 9 times out of 10, I get all my business, finance, and tech topics in via Morning Brew. Morning Brew is a free daily newsletter delivered Monday through Sunday. It is a 5-minute read, complete with witty, relevant, and informative essentials about the stock market, the business world, lifestyle, and of course, tech. Let me give you an example. Did you know that there is a helium shortage? Not funny, because this is actually a severe problem. National Weather Service warned that it would need to reduce the frequency of weather balloon launches for that exact reason. As it turns out, helium is critical to national security, something that the government knew way back in the day and decided to create a national stockpile of the gas in the 1960s. To learn more about such vital actualities, click on the link in the description to subscribe to Morning Brew today. It is completely free and takes less than 15 seconds to do so. Okay, so messages can finally be edited, and undo is a fact. Take note, Twitter. Any thread can be marked unread, which is probably the most exciting feature for me. Inviting someone for SharePlay lives in the messages too, which is like sending the simplest of invites for a group experience, and I love it. Dictation is now perfect in iOS 16. We can now write, record, rewrite, re-record, and mix all of this at the same time while composing text on the keyboard that stays open. Any text can be selected and replaced with voice. Live text now works with video, which means I no longer need to take a screenshot of something that I'd like to copy later. This feature should work across video platforms too. A quick show off was being able to separate an image from the background as a feature that is built into the platform. Now, I'm sure many separate apps that do that immediately went back to the drawing board. The Apple Wallet got a well-deserved upgrade where we will be able to share keys with people, including those that don't have an iPhone. What I was mostly excited about, however, was the tap to pay functionality, where if you are a small business, you can take contactless payments without the need of a terminal. Apple Pay Later was extremely clever too, where merchants that use Shopify, for example, will be able to provide more customer flexibility without lifting a finger. All taken care by Apple. Very impressive. To be honest, at one point I quickly got distracted and I missed what Craig Federighi was saying about Apple Maps, because he then wore a dashing tracksuit. Anyway, family sharing was something to appreciate as well. There will be a wizard to help set age-appropriate restrictions, and also being able to bring an iPhone nearby, a kid's iPad, for example, and set the permission on the air and on the fly. Screen time will now be managed via Messages too, which is very neat. Talking about family sharing, iCloud Photo Sharing Library will allow us to send the photos we take directly from the camera app, saving time and ensuring that everyone has the precious moments on the device without having to airdrop or iMessage moments like crazy. An important upgrade to the Home app was the new home connectivity standard called Matter. It is privacy-oriented, of course, and it allows various accessories to communicate with each other. The Home app, by the way, got overhauled a lot, which I think was long overdue, and will now make sense thanks to the clever breakdown and new categories like climate, lights, security, and others. CarPlay was shockingly good, but a bit misleading. At a glance, it will be the ultimate vehicle upgrade. Consistent interface that can spread around multiple car displays, widgets, instrument cluster options, and even themes, but it wasn't clear what it means for the average Joe who has only one screen and a car from like 2 years ago. Does Joe get any cool features too? We'll find out soon enough, so subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon. There were a lot of other iOS 16 features and upgrades that we will talk about in a separate video, like personalized spatial audio profiles and quick note, which accidentally I talked about in my previous video about the ultimate iPhone home screen, which I'll link at the end of this one if you wanna watch it. But anyway, WatchOS 9 introduced 4 new watch faces and banner notifications similar to the iPhone. One thing that stood out to me was the option to mute yourself from the watch while in a meeting. The rest of the announcements were focused on the active people and the new abilities to track your runs, for example. I like that we will be able to create custom workouts, definitely something that I'll utilize, especially the ability to race against the last workout that I did. I admire the health aspects of the Apple Watch too. Huge respect for the ability to monitor AFib history. Medications is also something that is fantastic, even for people that take vitamins and supplements. I can't even imagine how useful that will be for those that have to make sure that they take their life-depending medication. Oh, and drug-drug interactions sound an alert if there is a critical interaction between medications. Kudos, Apple. And just like that, the M2 entry-level processor was introduced. Now, don't get me wrong, I'll take Mr. Strategy presentation any day of the week, but I wasn't ready for hardware at this point. Now, M2 offers 18% faster performance than M1, 10-core GPU with 25% higher graphics, up to 24 gigabytes of unified memory, and support for a 6K external display, all in the body of the new MacBook Air. The new Air takes design cues from the later generation of Pro laptops, but it comes with only 2 USB-C ports, yet 4 colors. The display is now larger at 13.6 inches with, of course, the notch. It is, of course, light at 2.7 pounds and it has MagSafe. Battery life with the new performance on paper should be around 18 hours of video playback, but what went under the radar for most people maybe was the new compact power adapter. It has 2 USB-C ports that can charge 2 laptops at the same time and fast charge with 50% of juice in 30 minutes. Price-wise, the MacBook Air sits between the current dated generation of Airs and the 13 Pro, which honestly makes no sense. I mean, I get the old Air that stays available for, let's say, schools or businesses, but the old school Pro entry level makes no sense at this point. And now I'd like to take a second and ask this question. Who in the world of leakers came up with the name MacOS Mammoth? MacOS Ventura is here and introduces a new way of interacting with Windows called Stage Manager. Think of it as your normal way of interacting with Windows, but limited and more organized. This feature is useful, by the way, and it is the cornerstone for iPad OS, which comes later in the presentation. Think of Stage Manager as the ultimate dock assistant that lives on the left, which makes me think, what happens if you keep your dock on the left? Or can you choose where the Stage Manager displays? Anyway, we'll find out soon enough. Safari gets a revamp in the sharing department, and specifically the ability to share tabs with people. This comes in handy for teamwork and, let's say, organizing family trips. What I was most interested in was the next-gen credential method Apple calls passkeys. This new standard combines cryptographic and biometric options to deliver the most secure way to store access. Passkeys can be phished or leaked. You can use a QR code for cross-platform support. Metal 3 came in at one point, which I'm honestly too blown to talk about. So let's move on to continuity. Handoff on FaceTime was something that I could honestly only dream about. Imagine talking with someone and then switching seamlessly from the iPhone to the iMac or to the iPad. Not only that, but the iPhone can now be used as a web camera, which by the way requires no setup whatsoever. The Mac recognizes the iPhone automatically, and also center stage and portrait mode have never looked so good. Studio Light was something that got me too. What floored me, however, was the feature called Desk View, the ability to see yourself and the desk that you work on at the same time, sort of like a dual camera setup. As far as I can tell, this setup uses the front-facing ultra-wide camera of the iPhone mashed with some AI to deliver this dual camera goodness, which I'm honestly too impatient to try at this point. I'll never forget iPadOS, because as soon as I close my eyes, I see Greg Federici running. The most important iPadOS feature of the iPad is the release of the weather app. I can't believe it. There are even tappable modules. Okay, all jokes aside, weather app not being a joke, of course, there will be global operating system functionalities like undo, redo, extensions, folder size information, global find and replace, duplicate, export, and my favorite, a customizable toolbar. I'd like to give a huge shout out to the option to change the display scaling, which finally gives the option to optimize the space and take full advantage of the 12.9-inch iPad Pro. Of course, Stage Manager is a huge deal of the window operation of iPadOS 16, where we finally have full external display support. Windows can be resized and various layouts and app groupings can be created. At a glance, it all looks very intuitive, but we'll have to wait and see how the gentle overlapping of windows works in real life. On the secondary display, we will be able to create groups of 3 or 4 windows and have up to 8 apps running at the same time. Drag and drop across displays will work seamless. All this means is that it is time for a dedicated iPad desk setup. Now, during the keynote, there were quite a few topics that were left for future releases. One called Freeform. This will be the ultimate virtual whiteboard where people on FaceTime can meet and collaborate on drawing, sketching, writing, placing photos, playing video, audio, and PDF, including links, can result in the ultimate feature to elevate FaceTime status as a fully fledged and capable business alternative to, let's say, Zoom. Collaboration across all platforms was another focus during WWDC, where anything can start from a message or a FaceTime call. With collaboration, everyone can join a presentation, for example, and edit and work on a project with other people. If you enjoyed this video, chances are you'll find my software and apps playlist useful. This was my first WWDC coverage, and it's 3 a.m. for me, but it still has been an absolute pleasure. Time to go to bed. This is E. Over and out.